good evening to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. And on behalf of the organizers, Intelligent SME, the major sponsors, it's my pleasure and privilege to extend a very warm welcome and also give a big thank you for being here this evening with us, because without you, this evening would have no meaning. When I was called upon by the CEO of Intelligent SME to do this interesting assignment, I was challenged and perplexed to know more about who this wonderful person is. And as I started peeling layers and layers of his life's history, I realized I don't have one particular answer to the question, who is this person? And then I said, is he a business professional? To a large extent, yes, he is. Is he a successful business professional? Yes, that's what he is. Is he a social philanthropist? To a large extent, a man with a big heart. Is he something beyond that? Well, he's an outstanding polo player, winner of championships. Is that what it is? And then we found that he had other layers to him, which put him on the Royal Air Force of the United Arab Emirates. And then what else does he do? A hospitality major with degrees and diplomas from different parts of the world, and then comes back to ride the crest of success of the hospitality industry, with specific reference to the Al Habtoor Group, which by itself is 40,000 strong, a leader in many areas, including hospitality, construction, education, infrastructure, and various other fields. And is he a doyen of just all these various initiatives? I found there's a warm, gentle human being, a wonderful family person. I was trying to encapsulate the essence of who this person is, and what better than probably in the words of Steve Jobs, who said that the crazy ones are people who are very different, people who want to make a difference, people who want to change the world. The guest of honor this evening, Mr. Mohammed Al Habtoor, the Vice Chairman and the CEO of the Al Habtoor Group. A man who comes from a very illustrious family, but took to his passion, took to making a difference, took to being a little crazy in a wonderful sort of way, and thereby creating a unique mark for himself. And for the next 45 minutes, we're going to have a personal insight into this great human being. More than a great business person, I found a wonderful, warm human being, somebody extraordinary. So without much ado, may I request the guest of honor this evening, Mr. Mohammed Khalaf Al Habtoor, to kindly take the stage. Mr. Mohammed, I hope you don't mind me calling you Mr. Mohammed. Every wonderful story has a beautiful beginning. Tell us yours. Where did it all start? This person who's crossed all these boundaries, created this remarkable success story. Where did it start, sir?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Good evening, everyone. I'd like to thank the SPI group for inviting me this evening. The story is going to be long, Professor.
Please, we're all here to listen to that.
So when I went and finished my high school, my father told me, you have to go study hotel management. But actually at that time, there was nothing called Habtoor Group. There was Habtoor Engineering, which is a construction company, as everyone knows over here. And then there was the Metropolitan Hotel only, in Sheikh Zayed Road, which was built in 79. So I said, I mean, the construction was bigger. Why should I go study hotel management? Then I said, okay, maybe, you know, he has a vision on something. So I went and I studied hotel management. So when I went to study hotel management, I did only 6 months. It was in England. So he came, you know, he visited England almost like 6-7 times a year. So on one of his visits, he called me for lunch. He told me, so how was school? I said to him, I don't think I'm gonna do good in hotel management. And actually I was the first Emirati to study hotel management at that time. Anyway, he told me, so what do you want to do? I told him, you know what? I want to be pilot in the Air Force. He looked at me and he said to me, like, I think I'm crazy or something.
So now you know why the video is playing.
So he said to me, really, you want to be like a pilot in the Air Force? I said to him, yes. He said to me, but okay, pilot, and then what is the future there? I said to him, this is what I want, you know, that's my passion. He told me, okay, pack and take the flight tonight. I didn't even report to the school and tell them that I'm dropping the course or something. So I packed and I flew in the same time. My mother arrived, I arrived here, my mother was surprised, like, I mean, what are you doing? I said, that's it. Tomorrow morning I'm going to register in the army. Anyway, she told me, do what you want. So I went and registered, and you have to sign 15 years, and you cannot even exit. It's very difficult. So I did 2 years in the Air Force, which the most important thing that I learned after me being very naughty when I was a kid is the discipline. The discipline and the teamwork. We were like all of us, the officer cadets, pilots in the Air Force, we all in one heart. And this is actually what we implement usually with my team in the office. And also like with my family, with my brother, my sister, with my father, we try to have like all the teamwork for us to go to the second step. It's not one person decision. So anyway, 2 years later, I decided to leave. And when I left, it was a little bit difficult, so we had to involve many important people in the country here to release me. Anyway, I left. I went to my father. I told him myself. I told him, I want to go study hotel management.
Really?
So I went and I studied the hotel management. I went to England. I went to
US.
The US 2 times. And I met, of course, lots of people in the hospitality side there. Some of them are in Dubai here, because as we all know, the tourism and hospitality in Dubai is one of the top in the world. It is, top of the region and maybe top of in the world also. We have the best hotels in Dubai here. That's why everybody likes to come and work here. The facility, the services, there's nothing like it in the whole country here. So I went, I studied, I came back. The day I arrived, professor, ladies and gentlemen, I came on British Airways. I don't think there was Emirates at that time. I'm not gonna say my age now. So
we'll have a quiz.
So I landed, my driver was there, the house driver, so he came, dropped me. I found a note on the door of my room. Say, meet me 8 a.m. in the office from my father. It was like by the time I landed, to the house, it was like already 2 a.m. By the time I slept 3. I mean, I don't have a switch, you know, take time a little bit to sleep, you know, shower, change.
And jet lag
and everything. So anyway, I slept, woke up, I was maybe half an hour late. There was no problem. I arrived, we hugged, kissed, you know, didn't see him for a long time. And then he said, he rang the secretary and told her, call me Rahim. At that time, one of our executive managers in the company, in the hospitality side. So he came, so I met Rahim, hi, how are you? Gave me a piece of paper. I looked at the paper, says, 1 month cleaner in the housekeeping.
Wow.
Next month, porter carrying luggage. 2nd month in the kitchen, and so on. I looked at him, I told him, are you serious? Of course, what I was expecting, that I will arrive, find like $1 million office, beautiful secretary outside, you know, I sit there, orders, nothing of that what happened. I told him, I don't think I can do this. He pulled the paper, he told me, go find a job. And of course, down in the paper says 5,000 dirham, salary. So I was like, okay, so I just left the office. I went back home to complain to my mother.
Mom.
You know, they're always like, everybody goes to the mother.
Goes to the mother.
To put some, how do you call it, waspa. But,
local waspa.
But she couldn't. Because my father, like, when you try to debate with him, he became like more arrogant in that thing. So my mother told me, you do it, and I will help you when you need anything. I said, okay. So I went to him, I told him, okay, I'm ready to start tomorrow. He said to me, one condition. I said, what? Again,
what?
I mean,
what?
You have already like a big list of
conditions,
swiping the floor and everything. That's, you know, cutting onions. He told me, you have to wear a suit. You don't go with kandora. Hotel manager cannot be with kandora. You have to wear a suit. I said to him, I don't have suits. So he told me, okay, this is money, go buy suits now. So I went and bought suits. And of course, me being from Jumeirah, you know how the local boys, they came, they told me, oh, you're wearing suit. They started laughing at me. Like, they took it as a joke. They come to the restaurant and they say to the waiter, call us that guy, so I can take their order. You know, it wasn't very easy. It took really 1 year and a half being behind the reception. I have people who are not happy. They come and they just swear at you, bad words. You know, I swallow it. I go in the back, start like banging the table, you know, breaking a jar, you know, just to relieve the pressure. But very important. If you want to be a manager of a restaurant, you have to start a busboy. You cannot come say, I am Mohammed Al Habtoor. I want to be a manager of this company. What do you know about the company? What do you know if the waiter is serving the plates right, or if the food presentation is correct? And I wasn't happy at the beginning, but at the end, of course, I thank him until today for giving me the opportunity to do this from the beginning. Because if I came and sat in a big office, like $1 million office, I would be until today not knowing exactly what's happening under me.
Beautiful. I think it's fabulous.
I just wanted to ask you, finally, Sheikh Rashid's promise to your father has come true. There is an airport in Jebel Ali, finally. And I mean, that's why he built the Metropolitan in the first place, because Sheikh Rashid promised him an airport in Jebel Ali. Are you going to be building down in Jebel Ali?
When my father built the hotel, when Sheikh Rashid called my father early morning, he told him, meet me. And then went and told him, I want you to build a hotel here. So my father looked behind him, and he saw like he couldn't see even one building. At that time, you can see the beach. Jumeirah, there was nothing, just a few houses, villages, like every 20 houses together. And then there was the central military base also behind it. Then he told him, just build it, and we will see what, I'm building an airport here. Anyway, he passed away, Sheikh Rashid, at that time, after my father built the hotel. He was sick for a time, so the project was postponed. And then, as you see now, the airport is a little bit far. To come back to your question of building something closer to the airport, we had a few discussion about this. Actually, the government are now pushing to develop next to the World Central real estate hotels, four-star categories, and et cetera. So we started the discussion in the office a couple of times last week. But we will wait a little bit until we see what happens.